Hello everybody, what's up? It's Nico Strayhouse. I just hope you guys have a wonderful day today and just enjoy the very sunny and very refreshing weather recently. I think this morning I just went to witness the annual event in New Westminster, which is called the Hike Festival. I think that was pretty amazing. I just recorded some footages for that one. After the breakout of the epidemic, I think it is the first time that people just enjoy. Then people just join the event like this. Yeah, I think that is quite promising, and it's just like a sign. I think probably the life is not gonna be the life as it exactly like it before, but still, I think people just try their best to recover from the previous trauma. I think it is still like a very good thing. And I think for this weekend, for the coming week, it is gonna be like traditional Dragon Boat Festival. I think I already bought some sticky rice dumpling. I think I'm gonna make the steamed one. I actually bought two versions of it, just like the salty one and also the sweet ones. I think it's just like bring some vibe and bring some sense for the festival. And also I think in this episode of video, I'm gonna be make this one like the making a cuisine, because it's been a while that I haven't been cooking anything. And also I just plant some edible herbs, just like some different kind of spices like green onions, cilantro, thyme, sweet basil, and something like that. I just plant some stuff like this on my roof.
事件在他的银发和皱纹营造的安宁感中仿佛凝固了一般，他可能会静静地看书，静静地睡着，也会静静地死去。不止一次，每当 Patrick 正巧洗碗，抬头下意识地打量那个大大的落地窗时，总能看到这样一种凝固的场景。老人总是一个人静静地坐在椅子上，他可能会养了一只安静的黑猫，或许没有，但他周围的空间都是死一般的沉静。老人的家里都是白色系的装潢，白色的家具，白色的摇摇椅，白色的窗棂，还有白色的记忆。 Patrick 从未想过一个人会这么迷恋某一种特定的色调，白色是那么的让人觉得寂寞，特别是每当北美漫长的冬日来临之时，屋内的旷阔的白色条和着那窗外更加凝重的白雪混为一谈。他不害怕吗？ Patrick 想象着春暖花开，常春藤，或者爬山虎爬上老人单调的白色的窗栏，雀咬在枝头撒欢的鸣叫，和越来越浓被季节点染的绿意，这一切不安分的因子都会慢慢复苏。可是环绕老人的乏味的凝滞，就像是宫崎骏的作品里面呈现的完整的梦幻般的场景。人们宁愿让自己相信那些海市蜃楼都是真实的存在，是千与千寻里面穿过隧道而到达的，怪婆婆的宏大而诡异的风旅场，亦或是天空之城里面浮在于半空中的上一段文明的绿洲。人们相信这样的东西是不会消失的，它们凝固于永恒。或许直至 Patrick 离开这个寄宿公寓，开始自己新的生活的数年后，也能忆起这个有着些许乏味的白窗和窗后专注阅读的老太太吧。仿若一个被封存的相框，承载了一段或许不那么重要又抹之不去的记忆。